Everybody, Trenton here with Soundlink TV at the Vans Warped Tour in North Carolina. This time with Patty from As It Is. How you doing, man?
I am doing pretty good, thank you. How are you?
Pretty good, pretty good. So we talked to you a couple years ago on this, and I think you guys were selling your first record, so a lot's changed since then with the band.
Quite a lot has changed.
You've gotten quite bigger, got quite a following now. So what's this ride been like for you guys and As It Is and everything?
It's been cool, man. I mean, comparatively, we've got consistently bigger and better crowds. It's been fun. We've got our third record coming out in 2 weeks. So we've been playing two songs off that, and it's been going down overwhelmingly well. It's just been a really fun experience. I think more than anything else is just we know how Warped Tour works a little bit better this time, so we were a little better prepared, and just know how to kind of take the punches and stuff and kind of come out on the other side of it feeling all right.
Nice. And what's interesting is this is your third record, and every single one, even with the two new singles, it has a different vibe on it. The first one has a throwback sound, the second one's more of a upbeat poppy sound. This one has a little bit more of an edge to it and stuff. With this record, what is the whole theme with it and everything? Why did you guys go a little bit darker on this time?
More than just knowing it was kind of inherently and fundamentally where we wanted to go as a band, it was just exciting for a number of reasons. I feel right now in 2018 there's not many bands who are really feeling a strong sense of pride, projecting an outward sense of pride to be an alternative band. I think there's kind of a lot of bands in the scene are looking to pop and hip hop and going I think, we all want to take influence from that or kind of wish we were in that scene, and that's fine. But I think, what drew me to alternative music in the first place is kind of rejecting conformity. And that's what we wanted to do, is we're looking at a number of bands that really want to, not be part of the scene, and we're more than happy being part of the scene. We are proud of being on the Vans Warped Tour. We're proud to exist in this world and these publications, and more than anything, we're proud to have the fans that we do. So this is us kind of going we're a rock band, we're proud to be. Let's write a rock record.
So even with your whole style change and everything, is that something that's supposed to be going on along with this record and the whole dark theme, or what was the creative vision with this record aesthetically as well?
The record started with the title. It was the Great Depression. We knew what we wanted it to be about. We knew what we wanted the just kind of overall statement or exploration to be, but more so is we knew aesthetically everything about this record before we had a lyric or a song or a riff or anything. It was about paying homage to mid-2000s post-hardcore and emo,
Which I love.
Exactly.
So I'm digging it.
And just kind of playing the part, dressing the part, all this kind of stuff. And I feel so comfortable on stage. I feel so comfortable walking around Warped Tour or Brighton when I'm at home, just kind of with makeup and my nails painted. It's a cool feeling. But more than that, it's just kind of I remember when I got into some of my favorite bands, Newfound Glory and Blink and Green Day, that they would kind of pay homage to bands The Descendants, and NoFX, and Bad Religion. The bands really turned them on to this stuff. And it's we wanted to kind of introduce a new generation to the bands that meant a lot to us, British post-hardcore bands Funeral for a Friend and Alice for Heroes, 100 Reasons. And on the American side, you've got Under Oath, you've got Finch, you've got Armor for Sleep, Silverstein, all this stuff. So.
You missed the one everybody's commenting on YouTube about, though, My Chemical Romance.
Which is understandable. It's understandable, but it's not what I expected. It's because this haircut was just the haircut. It was this was every band. But I understand now. But at the time, it kind of took me by surprise. I get it. It's cool, man. Being compared to MCR, I'll take it. Could be way worse.
Definitely. So what is Warped Tour meant for you personally? I know you guys have done a couple of them and everything, and so growing up around it, I guess wanting to play it obviously and getting it to be a part of it a couple times, what's that experience been like? What does it mean to you and everything?
It's incredible. My family's all from Minneapolis, so I'd go to the Warped Tour I went three summers in the mid-2000s. But growing up in the UK, the band, all being English, never went to Warped Tour. So it was just this kind of mythical beast kind of thing. So being out here, being on the other side of Warped Tour, it's so much fun. But I think my favorite thing about Warped Tour is fans of bands get to watch their favorite bands watching their favorite bands. So we're out here watching The Used and Taking Back Sunday, Good Charlotte were here just yesterday, and all this super cool stuff. Newfound are going to be out soon, and I think it's something that's kind of refreshing and going to be missed, is just watching their favorite bands. It's so cool to still be a fan of music. I hate the whole kind of cool guy attitude, and that's just never been me. So, it's really cool. I think that's my favorite part of Warped Tour.
Okay, so you got a new record coming out in a couple of weeks and stuff. So by the time this is out, that record could be out.
Yeah.
So, what do you guys have coming up with that record tour-wise and stuff, and what can you talk about and everything?
So we're doing a couple exciting things. The biggest is that we're doing like our biggest headline tour in Europe and the UK. We're gearing up for that. That's going to be in November. But yeah, we're just going to put this record out. I think the most exciting thing is we're just going to let it kind of sit with people for a couple of months, and like everyone can get really excited about it. People can know every single word when we start playing these songs. It's going to be really exciting. And I love that we've only released two songs, and that there's still 10 that nobody has heard. I think it's one of the things I miss the most about consuming records as a fan, is that you kind of miss that Christmas Day feeling of like, wow, I haven't heard the vast majority of this record. So we were intentionally like, let's hold some of these back. And when we drop it, it's like there's still so much of this world to kind of like live for the very first time.
Yeah, that's something I've talked to some people about too, is like bands, you know, they're like putting out 3 or 4 singles, and by the time the record comes out, people have heard like half of them.
Yeah.
And so like I only listen to like maybe 2.
I understand the strategy, but it doesn't like fulfill me as a fan or as a creator of music.
Yeah. Okay, man. Well, thanks for talking to us today.
Of course.
Congratulations on the new record when it comes out, and on your tour later this year. I'm Trent with Soundlink TV, here with Patty from As It Is. Thanks for watching. Stay strong, hold on. You gotta keep it together.